For this topic, we're going to be solving word problems involving optimizations. Now, there are some series of steps that we need to consider when we're working on optimization problem. First, we need to identify the known and the unknown quantities, and we should only use one variable when solving optimization problem. We need to know how to find the critical numbers, and also we also need to know how to use the sign chart in finding the minimum and the maximum of our function. Now, after you're finished with all these steps, you need to reread the question to make sure that you have answered every single problem or every single sub-problems in the optimization problem. Now, let's have the first example. Now, in our first example, we need to find two numbers whose difference is 100 and whose product is minimized. So we're going to answer this problem using derivatives. So the first step is to write our equation based out of the problem. So the first two numbers that we're looking for will be x and y. X will be your first number and y will be our second number. And to write out the equation based out of the first part of the word problem, which is finding the two numbers whose difference is 100, can be shown as this. X minus y is equal to 100. Since we're only working with one variable, we can either isolate x or y. And in this example, I will isolate x in my equation, so I'll have x is equal to 100 plus y. So this is my first equation. Now I just need to work out the second part of the problem, which is whose product is minimized, and that's going to be shown in second step. So my second step will be to create or construct an equation based out of the second part of my problem. So minimized the product. Product means multiplication, so I'm going to multiply the two numbers x and y. And we know from our step number one that x is 100 plus y. So changing x to 100 plus y, now I only have one variable in this second step, and it's going to be 100y plus y squared. So notice that in my step one and in my step two, I have 100 plus y and I have 100y plus y squared. Both of these have one variable in their expression. Now, we're not finished with our work yet. You still need to answer the question by working with its derivative. So to summarize what we have done so far, so step number one, we were able to find x is equal to 100 plus y. And for second step, we have 100y plus y squared. Now to find your critical number, we're going to use the equation that we got from step number two. So that will be our function here, 100y plus y squared. And taking its derivative, we'll have 100 plus 2y. And setting it to 0 will give us the critical number. And we found out that the critical number will be y equals negative 50. And this critical number is what we will use in our sign chart later on to prove if it's maximized or minimized. But before we do that, we can readily solve for the second number because we already have y equals negative 50. If we use step number 1, we'll be able to solve for the value of x. So here, x is equal to 50. So now we're able to find the two numbers that we are looking for, negative 50 and positive 50. All we need to do is to prove if it's maximized or minimized. And in this case, I'm going to use the sign chart for step number 4. And in my sign chart, I'm going to use my critical number for my first derivative on step number 2. And I will use that to see if it's going to be a positive value or a negative value from the given interval. For anything lower than negative 50, just choose a number lower than negative 50. I chose negative 60 for my function, and I found out that I have a negative value using my sign chart for my interval from negative 50 all the way to the negative infinity. And for my second interval, I have 100 plus 2 times 0 because 0 is greater than negative 50, and I found out that it's positive. So therefore, my function for this particular optimization problem is minimized. Therefore, for step number 5, organizing my answer, I'll have the two numbers whose difference is 100 and whose product is minimized will be 50 and negative 50. And that's how we answer optimization problem in calculus.